10,000 people live in Strabane. For a place its size, it suffered more than any other community in Northern Ireland. This week, the Provisional IRA extended their bombing campaign to many country towns. The damage they have suffered is nothing compared to the Blitz of Strabane. 200 bombs in 5 years have reduced the town centre to rubble. Strabane has known happier days.
Strabane was a wonderful town to live in and to work in. Prior to the Troubles, it was a town where there was plenty of life, plenty of entertainment, plenty of places for the young people to go.
What's it like now?
Totally changed. Women, particularly mothers of teenage children and young children, are suffering from anxiety states and even depression. They're continually frightened. There's a fear that every time their children go out, they'll be involved in some happening, because if anything happens in the town of Strabane and you're down the town, you're involved some way or other. So when an explosion goes off, you can see fear in the people of their children and their safety. The housewife, she'll go down the town to do her shopping, possibly only once a week when she has to. The most of them are afraid to go out. I've known women who haven't been out of their houses possibly in 2 years.
Strabane is a small town tucked away in a distant corner of Northern Ireland. 5 years ago, Strabane was a quiet market town, and if you'd ever heard of it, it was because Strabane had the highest rate of unemployment in the United Kingdom. 25% of its men were out of work, and it had been like that for generations. For years, Strabane had been a forgotten town. Old industries had died. There was no work. Strabane was an obvious target for the civil rights campaign of the late 60s, and when the IRA reopened their campaign of violence, the ranks of the unemployed provided them with ready recruits. Strabane is a border town. The Irish Republic is 500 yards away across a river. This is where the Provisional IRA have their base, and this is where they retreat to, across a border that is notoriously difficult to patrol. The British Army are thin on the ground. There are only 90 soldiers to patrol the streets of Strabane and the miles of open border that surround it. The army and the police cannot check every car. They cannot search every passerby. Most of the population resent the army. Strabane is 90% Catholic. It has strong Republican traditions. But there's a particular reason why Strabane hates the army. 3 years ago, there was a civil rights rally. Afterwards, there was the routine stone-throwing session at the troops. Rubber bullets were fired. He'd been playing with a rubber bullet. A soldier thought he was aiming a pistol. He shot him and killed him here.
Did Eamon understand what was going on, what he was doing?
Well, not really in a case like that. He thought that was all fun. In his mind, I'm definite sure, he never would have thought that they would shoot anybody. You know, Eamon was on the impression the soldiers were here to make great peace. You know that. But he never would have dreamt on them shooting anybody. But Eamon had such regard for them, you know. He really was tickled pink with the army.
Do you feel bitter now?
You know, at times I do. When I think on Eamon, the life he had in front of him and how he really enjoyed life. But on the other hand, I think on those boys, somewhere, they have a mother too, those soldiers. And I dare say they're worrying about them the same as we worry about our boys. Thing can be done on the spur of the moment and regret it afterwards. But Strabane town will never forget Eamon and the way that he died.
This is Abercorn Square, the centre of Strabane. Outside that chemist shop, Two policemen were shot down late one night. One of them died. It's these border crossings which are the deadliest areas. Eight people have been killed around them, in rioting, ambushes, bomb explosions, and gun battles. One was a young girl caught in the crossfire. This is the regular Saturday afternoon shooting incident in Strabane. No one is hurt this time, except business. That's dead for the day.
People were running from the main street down to this place. They were all very scared, and mothers with small children. And they all tried to get into the shops. And the army was calling for everybody to stay in the shops. Everybody was terrified because she didn't know exactly where the shooting was coming from. Afterwards, when the shooting was over, the town was just deserted. There was about half an hour, just wasn't anyone to be seen. That was business finished for the day. And in this town, it's only two business days really that you have, is Friday and Saturday. And that just ended it for today, for Saturday.
But it's bombs, not bullets, that have done the most damage to Strabane as a town. This used to be the main hotel, the Abercorn. This was the other hotel, the Commercial. This was the biggest and cheapest supermarket in Strabane. This was the next biggest supermarket. The customs post has been attacked by the bombers eight times. The police station has been shot at, rocketed, and bombed from the air. The labour exchange has been bombed and rebuilt four times. Nine of Strabane's 10 petrol stations have been blown up. There used to be two banks on this corner, and this used to be Strabane's biggest building, the town hall. It was firebombed and burnt out. The only cinema closed down 2 years ago. The golf club has been bombed three times. 3 weeks ago, a bread van was hijacked and parked here in Strabane's main street. There was a bomb in the back of it. And when it exploded, it destroyed McGoldrick's the grocers and McKee's the insurance brokers, McGuinness's the opticians and Gray's the printers, McGrory's the drapers and Divine's supermarket, Campbell's the jewellers, Russell's the bakers and Klingon's dress shop. It also smashed Deary's windows for the 14th time. 60% of businesses have been hit by the bombers. Shop fast while shops last is the word in Strabane. The shopkeepers show remarkable resilience. Klingon's dress shop was destroyed by the car bomb. It reopened a few days later in a two-roomed rented flat. Eventually, shopkeepers will get compensation from the British government. The bill so far is over £4 million. Why haven't you packed it all in and gone away?
Well, this is my life. I'm too old to leave here now.
You'll carry on?
Carry on, yes, definitely.
Even if you get bombed again and again?
Even if I get bombed again and again.
And again?
And again.
We're asked this very often, how do you keep going, by people in quiet areas. Well, that's very easy to answer. You have no option but keep going. There is no alternative. You must carry on.
I think it's only a victory for the extremists if, when you're blown out, or blown out of business, that you stay out. The quicker you can get back in the more it proves to them that violence is not the answer.
The children of the estates still regard the Provisionals as their heroes. There aren't many Provisionals in Strabane, but there are enough who will continue to destroy Strabane until they extract more concessions from the British government. Until they're defeated, or until they win, or until they give up, Strabane will continue to suffer.
Is there anybody in Strabane who hasn't been affected?
I don't believe so. I think from the smallest children up, they are all conscious that Strabane has got a problem. Even the youngest children who can barely talk can tell you that big troubles. That's all they speak about.
Are there effects that will end when the troubles end?
No. No, even if the troubles ended tomorrow, we still have this great problem of the mental upset that has affected so many people. They will have to be re-educated, as it were, and brought back to realize that the troubles have finally ended. And it will not be easy, because a lot of these people are to some extent dependent on drugs now. That will all have to be changed around, and that takes time and patience.
Can Strabane return to the kind of place that it was?
It can, and it will. When the troubles finish, as we hope they will very, very soon, Strabane will start again to climb back. It will be a long and it'll be a difficult job. It won't be done overnight. But with the help of everybody pulling their weight, I think we can bring this back to the wonderful town that it originally was.
Despite all it's suffered in the past 5 years, Strabane can and will survive. But Strabane needs peace, and that won't come quickly or easily, because the political solution is a difficult one. So far, almost 1,000 people have died in the troubles of Northern Ireland, and there'll be more. If that's a figure that you find difficult to grasp, and if your patience sometimes wears a little thin with the constant stream of bad news from Northern Ireland, remember the human cost. Remember Strabane.